Talk to you later, Anna.
See you soon, Captain.
Alright. So let's go back to my cabin. This time actually read my logs. Or Alex's logs. The unreliable message terminal. Authorized login sequence recognized. Welcome, Captain. Alright, so I got messages for Alex Hawthorne, logs, and search term Sam. Let's check the messages. Viewing messages for user, Hawthorne A. Please select the following options. Hawthorne's unread messages. From U. Bedford. U. Dorn Wingman's Wingman Bedford to Alex Wingman Hawthorne. Thank you. Oh, I forgot to mention in my previous message. Silly me. I'm mailing you a copy of my favorite serial, The Space Adventures of Singularity Steel. It's about a dashing space pirate with a heart of, well, steel. It's not exactly board-approved, so don't you go showing it around to your spacer buddies. I hope it will amuse you while you're out adventuring. Any similarities to a certain someone are entirely intentional. Winky face, you darn. But that's his only message. Oh, right, we got archive messages and sent messages. Okay, two. From U. Bedford. Dearest Alex, I can't tell you how pleased I am to finally hear from you. Your message was hilarious. I'm delighted by your sense of humor and the tale of your hijinks. I hope your terminal will cooperate for this foreseeable future. By the by, I was scraping Groundbreaker's comms network for tasty little tidbits, and I noticed you declined to dock at Edgewater's landing pad and instead touched down in the wilderness. You rugged individualist, you. I only pray that idiot Thompson wasn't giving you any trouble. Anyway, I hope your meeting down on Terra 2 proves fruitful, and I look forward to corresponding with greater regularity. Your best friend, you Dorn. Subject, hello, hello. Alex, I don't know where you were raised, but I'd hazard to guess it may have been a barn, because anyone with even a modicum of decent rearing would know it's unforgivably rude to ignore the ardent, sincere messages of one's friends. Best, you Dorn, please, P.S., please respond. Well, he's probably dead at that point. Subject, checking in. Dear Alex, hello, hello. I hope this finds you well. It was a pleasure to see you in my office again last week. I guess this was earlier? Once again, I'm terribly sorry about the impending mix-up. How could it have happened a second time? Terminals these days, I swear, dreadfully unreliable. Aha, just like your ship. I hope you've given some thought to that thing we discussed, you know, about the Wells fellow. I'm so sorry to press, but I have the strangest tickling feeling that you really do know him. And if you could just tell me where he is, well, it would be marvelous for our friendship, wouldn't it? Looking forward to seeing you again, wingman. Winky Francis, your dear friend. You doing? Subject, a pleasure. Pleasure. Dear Alex, hello, Udorn here, Udorn Bedford. We met when I accidentally pounded your ship, my silly fat fingers embarrassing me once again. I guess this is the first message. I hope that was too terribly inconvenient for you. It was such a pleasure for me. And I tremendously appreciate your forbearance in not throttling me. You really are quite the gentleman. If you're ever in Groundbreaker's airspace, well, space, please don't hesitate to look me up. The Last Hope serves Spectrum Vodka. Perhaps we could try every color? You know, really tie one on. Let me know. Your new friend, you Dorn. Okay, sent messages. Okay, I have one to you, Bedford. No subject. Look, there's no call for shouting. My terminal was busted, had a few too many, and might have knocked it off the desk. You know how it is. Sometimes you just gotta cut loose. I'm not telling you where Wells is, so lay off. Buy me a drink at the Last Hope next time I'm in, and I might forgive you. A.H. Okay, so it wasn't because he died, it's because he knocked his terminal off, so that was not a new message then. Oop. And so this is all the messages, yeah. So we might find new messages here. Viewing log entries for user Hawthorne A. Log entry number one, titled Shrink Ray. Captain's note. Note to self, remember this later. No, better. Ada, remind me weekly to check this log until I tell you to stop. Yes, I mean continually. No, Ada, not if I'm dead. Why would you even ask me that? Back to my point, I saw in actuality with my own two eyes a sublimely powerful weapon in Wells' lab, just sitting there for the taking. If the gray hair were to look away, or forget about it, maybe, or if I had asked a smidgen more nicely, he called it a shrink ray, but wouldn't let me test that claim after I lost my temper. Said he was inspired to create the thing by the achievements of other scientists who dared to push the boundaries of human knowledge and decency laws. I had heard rumors of fantastical weapons like this one, weapons that pushed the boundaries of the mind and science's cutting edge, but I figured they were just stories, to be honest. Laying eyes on Wells' shrink ray firsthand is enough to make a fellow wonder if there's more to the rumors. More to be had, A.H. This is like Orson Welles. Or H.G. Wells. Log entry number two, titled Hammer Power. Hammer time. The last time I got sloshed, I mean, was imbibing at the last hope on the groundbreaker. Look, you... Is it you Dorn or you Dom? Here it looks like Udom. Udom was really free with the drinks. He seems like an okay fellow. I shamelessly but subtly eavesdropped on two Mardets yammering on about a mad scientist some years back who'd claimed he made a huge discovery that would change the fate of the colony. Like, none of us have heard that one before. But here is the good part. The Mardets said the mad scientist kept yelling about the hammer's power, or something similar. A strange weapon with a special power created by a crazy lab coat? Sure fits the bill. It could be another one of the weapons that inspired Wells. Log entry number three, titled Black Market Leads. Why won't Wells just give me the shrink ray to me? Blast him to the depths of the labyrinth on Tartarus and back. Let the record show I did apologize for shouting him down 5 times. But architect be damned, it's just sitting there, neglected and gathering dust. I should have commandeered it and thanked him without asking for permission or breaking expensive equipment when he said it wasn't ready yet, and that even if it were, he couldn't entrust it to someone like me. What does that even mean, I asked. I'm not trustworthy enough? That I'd use it to wipe out the good hard-working folks of the colony like some sort of moralist psycho? I'll admit to maintaining some questionable associations, but I follow a strict code of me, myself, and mine. What's not to respect in that? Exactly. Now I have to wait until Wells forgets or thinks he's misplaced it. In the meanwhile, I have been tracking down additional rumors pertaining to others of these science weapons throughout Halcyon. If gossip holds true, my next step will be to check with the black market merchants on the Groundbreaker and in Fallbrook. Search term Sam. First Sam result. Experimental note 01695. Do not forget, you found a discarded sanitation and maintenance automechanical in Emblevale scrap heap during your last job. It should not be too difficult to get it up and running. With a few key modifications, I can envision a combat capable variant. Some might say a clean, mean killing machine. Should be fun. A.H. Second same result. Removal of factory standard part Sud's steeper was successful. Delivery of combat modified replacement part acid steeper has been delayed. Progress setback is estimated now to be a solid 3 months. Not like I have more pressing matters to attend to. Ah, but I do. Third same result. And this gave me a lot of experience. 7200 XP again. Find an acid steeper. I'm giving up hope on the delivery. The part is lost in transit and is not turning up anytime soon. But, good news, I heard from a fellow who knows a gal who knows the broker who overcharged me for the information regarding the location of an acid steeper I can, filch. The part was sent to an old storage facility in Roseway. I sure never thought I'd go back to that pit. Good luck, Andy abandoned it years ago. I'll pick it up following this next pit stop back to Emerald Vale. Wells wants me to chaperone some person of interest. Details to come later. A.H. Acquire finishes science weapon and acquire the science weapon on Groundbreaker. Logs found in the captain's terminal on the Unreliable mention finding a powerful weapon. Perhaps the Halcyon colony contains other weapons which, like this one, push the boundaries of what science can achieve. It'd be worthwhile to seek out these devices, these science weapons. The logs on Hawthorne's terminal mention rumors from the Groundbreaker of a scientist who bragged about a powerful weapon he was researching. Perhaps more details can be found on the station. Another of Hawthorne's log mentioned looking in Gladys's shop for old records. Apparently the smuggler acquired several leads this way. The logs on Hawthorne's terminal indicated that Phineas has a powerful weapon at his orbital lab. You found entries on Hawthorne's terminal in the captain's quarters regarding his attempts to turn Sam into a combat-capable unit. Hawthorne planned to replace Sam's suds steeper with an acid steeper, but never picked up the part from Roseway. Phineas Wells wants you to contact Gladys, a black market fence located on the Groundbreaker, the only neutral section in the Halcyon colony. She can sell you a nav key to Stellar Bay on Monarch. Oh, stuff here.
I find myself marveling at the complex simplicity of the... Something vexing you, Captain?
So you have to find this part. I wonder if... Where'd she go? Where'd Parvati go? She go to hanging out in her quarters instead? I don't know where she went. This one's not hers. This is her. So she's not in here. That's funny. I wonder where the hell she went off to. I could sleep there if I want to. Look, so far this is the only place we can sleep on the ship. Oh, she's hanging out here.
Something busted, Captain?
Nope. Alright. As you were. Oh! That's silly. So, slept up to two companions to accompany you. Okay. So, I have a total of six we can have. Deserters forced to return by heroic stranger. The salvation of Emerald Vale. Miracle on the frontier. The Halcyon Observer. 2 bits. Okay, so now we're at the landing pad. Cool. So we land, we'll be here from here now on. Well, you know I'm going for some more of this. I have some stuff to sell that I actually found on the ship. It's not just a suit and a deck of cards anymore. Spade. Get it. A one-handed shovel that's surprisingly effective at staving off small animals from farms. They have magpies. Yes to those. By patient. How much money do I have? Plenty still. Some more ammo here. You just don't wear anything, so. This area is great because you got these four vending machines all close together. So if you need stuff. These are zero as well, right? Yeah. By the cannery. Number one, I want to check out what's going on, see if things have changed, if we can find Adelaide over there. And there's some vendors as well, vending machines anyway. Yeah, this is a good place to come in. Because the cannery's right here. I always forget where the other one is. This way? This way. Down there. That's not it. Really wonder about that. Oh yeah, in here. Look at all the mag picks we have. There's quite a few things that we didn't get to unlock. I could go around and collect all that stuff, but eh. There's no one in here now. Unlike before.
Okay, quiet.
There was always someone in here. Bits in there. Sweet. That's awesome. So I can sell the stuff right here. That's about it. All I'm selling though. Okay. It's not a see if she has anything new to say.
What's on your mind?
She just tells you about Eugene. See if we got an Adelaide here. Oh, I was like, where is she? There she is. Sweet. These guys have anything new to say.
Good to see our old workers came back.
Got my sights on you.
Yeah.
Time changes all things. Even Reed's stranglehold over Edgewater must inevitably yield to the attrition of time.
Now that Reed's gone, what do you plan to do?
Start anew. Edgewater will become the town it was meant to be. A place where we live in harmony with the world. Where none of us writhe under the whips of corporate masters. A place where all are welcome. Except for Reed's supporters, of course.
Are there any... these people no longer Spacer's choice? I was wondering about your garden.
The garden will bloom anew. I have plans to transform the old cannery into a nursery, with crops enough to feed a town.
You're still using corpses in the fertilizer.
But of course. And now we have a whole cemetery to ourselves.
You can use animal corpses too, you know that. Are you concerned about the plague?
Saltuna was making the town sick. From now on, if anybody's hungry, they may feast from the bounty of the soil.
Oh, take care. Requires Reed's key. How do I get Reed's key? Maybe if we do more stuff for her, she'll give us Reed's key, I don't know. Or maybe I could have pickpocketed it off of him or something while he was still there. That's cool looking. These people won't freak if I take out my gun, right? Just sightseeing, you know? This is her house. I wonder if she has anything to say when she comes in here. No?
Yeah, huh?
Alright, never mind. Alright, let's go back to the ship, I guess. I was thinking about the general store, but eh. What does the Codex want now? We're just talking about quest dependencies. Oh. See, now that our ship's not there, we can't fast travel over there. The unreliable interior. The entire interior is unreliable. so... When next we... when I see you next, we'll be heading off to another planet. I guess we're heading to this, or we're heading to a starship. Groundbreaker. I guess heading to the Groundbreaker next. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. Okay, I just had this error happen. See you in the next episode, guys, and see you next time. Always, seek adventure.